Hi everyone! This is a video where I show how to assemble a 3D printed medium format camera for Mamiya Press lenses. This is the third version of the camera. The first two work nicely, but a lot of things could be improved. The main improvements are the addition of a viewfinder and a red window to advance the film more precisely. Also, the film advance mechanism is now fully 3D printed. You can check the two previous designs in printables, for which you have a link in the description. Both previous models shot 120 film in 6x6 format. This new one shoots 6x6 and 6x4.5 formats. This first part is the outer body. Printing details such as nozzle diameter, printing direction and supports information are included in the 3MF files in printables. I tried to select printing parameters to optimize overall quality. One of the not 3D printed parts is a tripod thread nut, which can be inserted mid-print without the need of pausing the print. This is the lid of the camera. It is printed with a 0.8mm nozzle, same diameter as for the outer body. I didn't find necessary printing these bigger parts with a standard 0.4mm nozzle. Tolerances are good as printed, but filing is sometimes necessary to achieve the best fit. I use Prusament PLA in Galaxy Black and Marble Grey for the whole build. The knob supports are really easy to remove. It is glued to the axle using, if possible, a specific glue for rigid plastics. The knob and axle goes through the lid and are secured with the gear-shaped part. The axle and the gear must be glued, being careful not to glue them to the lid. This gear is part of the ratchet mechanism that will help maintain the tension of the film inside the camera. The inner body is printed in two separate pieces. First, so that material support is not needed, but mainly because a couple of magnets are glued in between. Those magnets will hold the parts that will act as the 6x4.5 adapter. The downside is obvious. Those parts must be aligned and glued too. The magnets can be oriented anyway, but I would recommend to position them with the same polarity towards the inner cavity. Two threaded inserts on top of the inner body will later ensure that the camera is securely closed with a couple of screws. Apart from the gear-shaped piece, the ratchet mechanism consists of a pivoting part and a spring. When installed, the knob should move anti-clockwise freely when looked from the inner face, and not move at all in the other direction. The last parts to be glued to the inner body are meant to keep the film spools in place. They are flexible to allow us to introduce the film, but rigid enough to keep it in place. The 6x4.5 adapter consists of two parts that will sit on top and at the bottom of the inner cavity and will block the light on those areas. They are attached using magnets. The orientation of the magnets must consider the one used on the magnets on the inner body. Threaded inserts are also used in the outer body to secure the front plate, where the lens will fit, and accessories like a handle or hooks for a strap. In order to ensure a tight fit of the film inside of the camera, I'm using a paper template to cut a 1.5mm thick foam to act as a pressure plate. For the red window on the back of the camera, I'm also using a paper template to cut a 2mm methacrylate sheet. The templates for the foam on the window are available in printables and must be printed at 100% scale. A transparent red film is used in addition to the methacrylate to reduce the most harmful wavelengths into the camera. The last 3D printed part is the front plate. It will hold the lens in position. In general, support removal is easy, but for this part it's a bit more complicated due to small geometries. The assembly itself is quite easy. The lens is introduced in the front plate and secured with an M3 set screw. The front plate is secured to the main body using M5 countersunk bolts. Now, before placing the film, it is time to decide the format we will be shooting. If we want to shoot 6x4.5, we would place the adapters as shown. Loading the film is similar to other medium format cameras. but in this case we must be sure to keep the film as tight as possible during the process. And even better if we load the camera inside a dark room. The camera is closed using M5 protruding head screws, but they sit flush with the camera. When rotating the knob, you can see the film advancing through the window. The left numbering corresponds to 6x6 format, and the right one corresponds to 6x4.5 format, as marked into the box icons below the window. The viewfinder is a 28mm TTR design viewfinder, which suits nicely for my Mamiya 100mm lens. But a frame must be added in front for easier framing. Both 6x6 and 6x4.5 frames for this lens and viewfinder combination are included in printables. I also designed a handle for a cable shutter. All parts needed for the camera, including the cable shutter, are listed in printables. Hook straps can also be attached to the camera, and in fact, any accessory you wish to design. The distance between the threaded inserts are 34mm horizontally and 66mm vertically. But the camera, without any handle or strap, is also quite nice to use by itself.